Vampire. The Vampire is a dark epic fantasy novel. It's set in a medieval European setting, but it's secondary world fantasy, so it's somewhere entirely new. And an environmental cataclysm has occurred called Day's Death, which means the sun doesn't shine as brightly in the sky anymore, essentially. And along with all the war and famine and destruction that comes along with a normal environmental catastrophe like that, in this world, vampires are real, and they figure out that the sunlight no longer kills them, and so they start popping up around the country and slowly taking it over. The novel is about a character named Gabriel Deleon. He's a member of a religious order. They're called the Silver Saints, and essentially they are monster hunters. And he begins the novel in the captivity of his vampire enemies, and he is forced to tell his life. The story kind of takes place over two time periods, one when he's a young man and he's first indoctrinated into the order, and the second when he's a much older man and he's dragged kind of unwittingly into a quest for the one thing that might be able to bring the sun back to the sky, which is the Holy Grail. So that's it in a nutshell. I have loved vampires ever since I was a kid. One of the first novels I ever remember reading was Salem's Lot by Stephen King. I was 10 years old at the time. I was very small, probably way too young to be reading that book, but it's still one of my favorite novels, and I've loved them ever since. I grew up. Interview with the Vampire is still one of my favorite novels. Lost Boys and Near Dark are some of my favorite films, so I've always kind of been steeped in vampire lore. The very first novel that I ever wrote, which is a terrible novel, never got published. Most first novels are terrible novels, but the first novel I ever wrote was also a vampire book. I've just loved them forever. And one of the ideas in that first book, I actually recycled and reused 12 years later when I wrote Empire. So if you're an aspiring author, the lesson there is never throw anything away. But yeah, they're a really interesting topic. They started as villains and kind of prototypical monsters that humanity fought, kind of a light versus dark situation. But over the course of the last 20, 30 years, they've become romantic figures. They've become tragic anti-heroes. There's a bunch of different perspectives, but I wanted to kind of harken back to the monsters that I grew up with when I was that little 10-year-old kid reading Salem's Lot. So yeah, the vampires in my novels are, they're like an evil that humanity has to fight. And the book isn't really about vampires. It's about people who are trying to survive in a world that has been brought to the brink of destruction by vampires. So they are definitely the enemy in this one. I was raised religious. I was raised Roman Catholic and I went to a religious school, and a lot of the religion in my novels is me trying to work out my feelings about it. Even when I was a young boy, a lot of the things that I was being told by people who claimed to know a lot more than me didn't make a lot of sense. And some of the questions that Gabriel asks in Empire and some of the questions that Mia explores in Never Night insofar as God and religion is concerned are kind of me arguing with myself sometimes, trying to present both sides of the question and the answer. I don't want to be a writer on a soapbox. I don't want to be a writer who is preaching to people and telling them what to think. I would rather be a writer that prompts question in my readers. So I'm very careful not to be too one-sided and present kind of an even hand and allow readers to make up their own mind. Like I say, I don't want to tell you what to think. But hopefully some of the questions that I pose in the book makes you think in a different way. That's the goal anyway. I'm not sure if it works, but that's what I try to do. Empire took me 3 years to write. 3 years working on it on and off. Not kind of every day. I was working on other novels as well, but it was 3 years work. And like I say, the original idea for Empire is 12 years old. So in one way, shape or form, I've kind of been working on this novel for over a decade. It was the hardest novel that I ever wrote. There's some very dark moments in it, and while I was writing it, the world was kind of going through the pandemic. So there was a kind of a lot of darkness without and a lot of darkness within. And some of that has kind of permeated the text, but it's honestly it's the best book that I've ever written. It's the book that I'm most proud of because it was so hard to do. And even though it was a struggle, what came out at the end is something that I'm incredibly proud of. And even though it's dark, hopefully there's kind of a thread of light that runs through the narrative. So I hope you enjoy it, tell your friends about it, and thanks for reading.